If you just clicked on this video and enjoy being happy, I suggest you don't watch any further because I'm going to be covering one of the most disturbing movies I have ever watched, called The Divide. Okay, there's your warning. Let's get started with the video. If you were trapped in a bunker after nuclear war broke out with everyone from your apartment complex, would you be able to survive as everyone goes crazy? I'm Andrew from Obsessive Films, and I'm going to be going over the mistakes the characters made in the movie, as well as how they could have potentially survived The Divide. Our movie begins as a lady stares off into the distance as a tear rolls down her cheek, and we can quickly see why she's crying. It's because a nuclear bomb has gone off into the distance and nuclear war has started. Now, I just wanted to say that this scene is unrealistic as fuck, because if you stared at a nuclear bomb like it was some hot girl's tits, you'd probably instantly go blind or at least get some sort of vision damage. So if you see a bomb, just run away next time. Soon after the blast hits, the residents run towards the bunker. However, only a few of them make it inside before the door is slammed shut. Now, obviously, the owner of this bunker probably could have let a few more people inside before closing the door, but remember, the more people you let inside, the less food you'll have. So I actually support his decision to close it on everyone trying to get in. We then peer into the bunker and see a bunch of ordinary people who made it inside, along with the owner of the entire apartment complex named Mickey, who also has some sort of survival experience as he tapes up all of the ducts to prevent radiation from leaking in. This guy Mickey is also a fucking Sigma, since he decides he's the owner of the building and gets to set all the rules. There are only two. It's that no one goes into his office, and that he's the boss and everyone should listen to him if they want to live. We soon see that the building on top literally starts to collapse, so going outside is no longer an option, especially with all the radiation in the air. We can even see that there's a kid inside the vault, but Uncle Mickey, unfortunately, well, he's not the nicest guy.
Sweetie, but Uncle Mickey says we have to stay.
The last thing you're gonna want to do in this situation is to get close to that kid, because that would certainly mean that you're gonna form sentimental connection to the kid, it's gonna be hard not to give up food to the kid when it's hungry, and it's gonna be harder to kill the kid and eat it in case you run out of food. And also, kids are just fucking annoying, so, fuck them, kids. Wait a minute.
FBI, open up!
Our movie progresses to everyone feeling pretty comfortable in the vault, but this dumb fuck named Delvin, who somehow made it out of engineering school, rigs a radio and tries to contact the outside world. Although this could have been a good idea if it were a small-scale disaster, literally nuclear war was going on outside. The only people you're gonna invite is the enemy troops, bandits, or looters who are looking to kill you and take your food. Even if the government was still standing, they wouldn't even make helping you a top priority. The movie then fast forwards to Mickey giving everyone a tour of the bunker, and we could see they don't have much. They have some beds and a toilet without running water, so don't even ask me how that smells. Luckily though, the group can take their time and eat some delicious beans. Like, imagine having beans and toilet without running water combo. Imagine how bad that smells. After the group finish eating, three gangsters, two of which are brothers, decide to get up and break out of the vault. I don't know where the fuck they plan to head to, but Mickey is able to fight them off with an axe, and this shows that the group really isn't bonding as well as we thought they would. Now, this probably sounds really psychopathic, but I would probably just wait for the three gangsters to go to sleep and kill all three of them, because the last thing you want is for an all-out war to break out inside the bunker and for you to die. So if I were Mickey, wait for him to go to sleep and slash him a few times in the throat with that axe. However, before tensions can settle, someone starts drilling into the door of the bunker, probably thanks to the guy with the radio. After the door has been drilled open, a bunch of futuristic soldiers who may or may not be human start walking inside of the bunker, and the group sort of just looks at them and pleads to not shoot. If I were in the situation, I would have definitely hidden to the back of the vault before that door is even open. Because even if the soldiers don't kill you on the spot, the radioactive material coming inside the door would probably kill you later anyways. At first, the soldiers appear friendly and don't just start shooting at everyone on the spot, until they start taking away the little girl which they find hiding behind her mother and injecting her with some strange syrup. They then bring the little girl out in a body bag as the mother attempts to chase. However, she fails and the soldiers start shooting at the group. The girl from the beginning of the movie, whose name is Eva, decides during the gunshots she should run to the shower. However, I don't really think this is a good idea, especially because she just stands there and does nothing. Instead, she could have at least laid down on the floor so no one could see her through the shower curtains and minimize the chance a flying bullet would randomly hit her. Whether through sheer luck or extremely powerful plot armor, the group is able to fight off all of the guards, killing all of them without losing a single member. The only thing that happened is one of the gangster brothers ended up getting shot on the shoulder, but he's fine. The group think of a really retarded rescue plan where they strip the suit off the body of one of the fallen soldiers who turned out to be Chinese, and then plan on using that to go find the daughter. This just does not make any sense. Sending one dude out as a soldier is just suicide. There's no way they're not guarding the door in real life if they figured out some of the soldiers just died inside that door. Of course, because this movie is unrealistic as shit, there's just some strange tunnel with no guards leading out of the vault. So it seems that the soldiers have built some sort of base around the vault. The guy the bunker sent out has walked into a makeshift lab with other soldiers when he finds there's a bunch of kids in test tubes waiting to be experimented on. And he finds a little girl. However, before he can do anything, the soldier outs him as an imposter and a chase ensues. He's able to make it to the vault, not before experiencing extreme PTSD, and he lies to the group saying that the kids were gone, not wanting to tell them the truth. Now, if you've made it this far in the video, I can tell you that this is when the movie starts getting more and more fucked up. Now, you can kind of see where the movie is taking a turn, because as soon as they get back to the vault, the dead bodies from the soldiers start smelling really bad. So they need a way to dispose it, so they decide to hack it into pieces and throw it into the toilet. However, they discover that they have a psychopath within the group who really enjoys chopping up bodies. The group dynamics in this movie start getting really weird when Marilyn, the mother who lost the child, and Sam, the soldier who went out to find the child, start entering a romantic relationship. Probably because they both have pretty bad PTSD and they just want someone to bond with. And Delvin, who is clearly running low on water, decides to be a fucking idiot again and do a bunch of push-ups, making him more dehydrated in the process. However, he does get a sneak peek at Mickey coming out of his room, seemingly out of nowhere. Because of this, the group decide they've had enough of Mickey being an asshole and they rebel and take over his office, everyone sitting inside enjoying his food and watching his movies. And a few minutes later, things get even more weird when Marilyn starts having sex with the other gangster named Bobby on a couch. After the group leaves, Delvin threatens Mickey with a nail gun, saying that he saw that he has a vault, and forces Mickey to open it. After going into the vault, Delvin and Mickey end up getting into a fight, which results in Mickey killing Delvin. We quickly learn that this vault was full of food and also had an exit to the outside. So at this point, if I were Mickey and I had already killed Delvin, I would have just locked myself in the vault, ate all the food, and eventually when I wanted to, I could just leave when all the radiation settled. But because Mickey doesn't do this and he confesses that he accidentally killed Delvin, the group decide to tie him down, put him on trial, and interrogate him for the code. They eventually choose the highly effective method of chopping the fucker's two fingers off until he revealed the code, and he did. After this whole series event, everyone seems to be in a slightly bad mood, except for Marilyn, who seems to still be wanting sex from this guy, who clearly doesn't want it anymore, and they start degrading the fuck out of Marilyn. And they start degrading her so hard that she starts reverting to some primitive mindset or something, and she starts acting like a dog. And that's just really fucking weird, because I'm not into furries. Eva and Adrian, who appear to be the final two normal human beings in the vault, go and have a drink together, and they decide that they want to escape and leave everyone else behind. So Eva goes to Mickey, who seems to be the only person who actually knows what to do in a disaster, and it turns out he was actually pretty smart. He said that he acted like an asshole and held all the food because he wanted to know who he could trust, and when the supply ran low and everyone got desperate, who would turn on him. In order to gain Eva's trust again, he reveals that there's a gun in a coffee jar nearby. And the extremely fucked part of the movie is Marilyn is literally right now being used as a sex slave and kept in a cage while being constantly drugged so she can't resist. Now, if I were Eva in this situation, I would know that after Marilyn, they're probably gonna be sex hungry and come after me next, considering I'm a lot hotter than Marilyn as well. So I'd probably get the gun, free Mickey, so at least you have a chance to defend yourself. You could see that whether due to isolation or radiation, the two brothers start going insane. They shave their heads and apply makeup in an attempt to become mirror images of one another. Meanwhile, Eva, who is still frantically looking for the gun, runs into the two brothers and they attempt to rape her. As she leaves, she literally sees it's not going great for her because they literally raped Marilyn to death. Eva hatches a plan with her cuck husband, who I haven't talked about this entire time. Her husband basically has a really bad anxiety disorder that makes it so he can't really talk to people and he can't look people in the eye. He's basically just a massive pussy. So she pretends to have sex with one of the brothers, and then her husband is gonna go grab the gun. After the husband gets the gun, there's a standoff where all the people in the vault are gathered in one room. However, in true retard fashion, the husband gets a panic attack and when everyone starts talking to him and accidentally shoots the good gangster instead of the bad ones, who literally have their hair shaved off. Like, it's not too hard to tell them apart from everyone else. As a result, he gets his ass beat, but Eva, luckily, is able to quickly slit one of the bad guy's throats with a can. but not after the good gangster dies, of course. So Eva lets Mickey out of his restraints and he's able to shoot one of the bad guys. However, for some reason, he doesn't finish him and just lets the bad guy sort of wander around injured, which gives him time to throw a lamp on the floor to trigger a massive fire. Eva, seeing an opportunity to ditch these two retards, decides to lock them with the fire in a cage and put on the suit herself. She then packs some food and goes through the sewer as Mickey and the other retard burn to death. On the outside of the bunker, however, she finds that everywhere is just as bad, if not worse, than the bunker. And once again, we get a zoom in on her face at the end of the movie, just like we did in the beginning. Okay, I know that was a lot to take in, and I probably explained it a little bit fast, but here's a quick recap of what happened in the movie, okay? Everyone but Eva for sure died, okay? One girl actually got raped to death. Okay, Eva will most likely die because she doesn't have much food and she has nowhere to go. Everyone pretty much went crazy and got radiation poisoning, and two people inside the bunker literally became animals. So yeah, that was a pretty fucked up movie, but thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this How to Beat video. If you have any tips for the characters to survive this movie, feel free to comment them below, or if you have any suggestions, you could comment those below as well as subscribe and like if you enjoyed this video. This is Andrew from Obsessive Films signing out. I'm on the move. Can't stop me if you try.